Hey, Sashan, what is going on? Is my light bulb using tungsten or incandescent? Come on. I guess we're gonna be tungsten today. So, I'm noticing a pattern with the AIs that make this artwork. So-called artwork. Artists are, I don't think they're in panic mode yet. I don't think they're gonna get replaced by the AI yet. This thing's only been for, I don't know, 6 weeks? 6 weeks, and this video was made 2 weeks ago. Probably using what's the diffusion thing? 1.5 or something. Maybe 2.0 by now, I don't know. But the it's Midjourney's AI. There's like four different versions of it to pick from when making your things. But I just want to show real quick. Okay, this is Wizard of Oz as an 80s steampunk movie. Easy peasy, right? There's already something here. The AI, this is the default face for women. The AI always picks this face, the nose, the lips, the eyes. So it's like Midjourney used to do other faces. Or is it to the point where people are copy pasting other people's stuff and they like that face and they just keep telling the AI to use this face, keep using this face? You know, enhance, enhance, enhance. I mean, that could be the case. But there's also a dude that shows up. And I want to say the dude is like the default face for dudes. It's like Victoria 3 and Michael 3 all over again in the Daz 3D world. So when you see this face, you know right away, oh, it's AI, because you recognize the face. It's like this is when you say, I need a woman dressed up as Dorothy in Wizard of Oz, you're gonna get this face. Anyway, same face, same kind of eyeballs, same kind of, same kind of stare going on. This one's kind of messed up. That one's messed up, but still the same face. I was doing, I don't know if I did a video on the Fantastic Four, but I sent a link to my brother. He watched it. He got a good laugh out of it. But yeah, there's a Fantastic Four. If it was a movie made in the 60s, something like that. And it looked really cool, but again, the guy and the girl are the default AI faces. Now, if the AI can't make more than two or three faces for humans, then I don't think artists have anything to worry about. Because if I can tell from looking at a face that it's an AI painting, not a photo or not some artist's rendering, but if it's just AI doing it, just from the face, then if I can do it, a million other people can do it. They're like, oh, that's AI. That's everyone's gonna laugh when they see this face. 3 months from now, everyone's gonna laugh when they see this person's face. They're gonna be like, oh, you're still using that AI? Oh, this one's kind of different. Got Dorothy mixed with the lion, Dorothy mixed with the Tin Man. Here's the face again. There's the face. By the way, here's the guy's face, but we'll see more later. Same face, just older. In a previous video, I was trying to think, who is that? Is that Susanna York? Is it Oh, who's the other actress? Maude Adams? Is that her name? Some would say maybe Grace Kelly. It's like, I think you need to start throwing in photos of actual actors, but then the AI is just going to use that actor's face, right? Is this like 1984? Big Brother, any of you ever see the poster of Big Brother himself? It's a conglomerate face of Hitler, Stalin, Mussolini, all the fascist leaders and dictators. His face is made up, copy paste, to make a generic dictator. That's who Big Brother is. And I wonder if the AI, the people at Midjourney have thought, you know what, this face will be all the women faces we've stolen off the internet. This is gonna be like the mishmash of it all. I don't know what that's called. When you mash all the white chicks, get all the white chicks, put them together, and you come up with this supreme being. What is that called? You're not doing the average of the pictures. Oh, there's a name for This is her looking mean. I'm not even paying attention to who the character is or what the outfit is. It's just, okay, there's the AI girl again. This time with the 50s do, kind of, sort of. More like a Mae West thing going on. Again, same face. Same face. This guy, I want to say it's Dr. Moriarty from Star Trek Next Generation, who's also in Picard season 3 or something. But, the people make this is drops fiction. They have these. I wonder if it's the same person just doing these videos with different video channel names, hoping one of them goes viral and gets the 150,000 subscriber count they're hoping for. Because most of these guys are getting, they get a lot of views, but they don't get subscriptions. You know what I mean? The key is to get not only a lot of views, but you want a lot of subscriptions. That means you have to get new viewers each time you post a video. You can't just be getting the same viewers each time you post a video. No, that's what I do. That's nonsense. You're supposed to post a video and get brand new viewers each time you post a video. Anyway, yeah, so the guys or gals making these videos, they're gonna lose interest when they see that there's a plateau that they reach. There's like a certain number of people even remotely interested in these kind of videos. I'm half interested in it. I'm more interested in it technical wise. I'm not looking at it like, oh, this is great artwork. Oh my goodness, this was done by a computer. No, I don't do that nonsense. It's just after I've seen a few iterations of this stuff, I just notice, you can change the robot outfit, the dress, the thing, the Tin Man lady look. You can do all the make her hair look like gold bricks, all that stuff. Even introduce LED displays in a steampunk 80s movie, I suppose. I don't know. To me, they would not be using LED. They would be using either fluorescent numbers, or they would be using not fluorescent numbers, but the oh, what's the one? Tungsten, the tungsten numbers. Or they would be using numbers like in THX 1138, the numbers that flip, that kind of thing. Even with the masks, when you say do a metallic face or something, the AI is going to give you one of three choices, basically. It's going to be this look. Like you say, I want Iron Man's, I want to do an Iron Man. It's going to give you this kind of a face for both the Iron Man, for the Green Goblin, for Ant-Man, all that kind of stuff. Just change variations on the painting, the shininess, the leatheriness, the plasticness of the material. That's all it's gonna do. But the basic style, shape, everything, the jawline, it's all gonna be the same. How are the hands doing, by the way? You got four fingers, five fingers? Okay, one, two, yeah. I haven't been paying attention to the hands in this video. How many fingers do you got there? One, two, three, four. That's a lot. But the main giveaway now seems to be the face. I was thinking it was the eyes. It used to be the eyes would give it away, but that was when the faces were always different. They were sort of mannequin-ish, human-looking, but the eyes were just, oh, you would notice right away that something's wrong with the eyeballs, the eyelashes, the eyelid. Why is one eye looking like a fisheye? That kind of thing. But now the eyes look good. But what the I think the eye just whoever's doing the AI thing probably just manually says the eye looks like this, dude. Okay? When you need to render an eyeball, just use this one. Don't go searching for what an eyeball is. With the Tin Man Scarecrow mishmash. Oh, I see. Yeah, that's right. It's a steampunk thing. So, yeah. Steel plating on all the characters. I forgot about that. Is one of these a lion? Wait, here's this. That was the same face. That was the same face, just really, really old. Really, really old. It's almost like a guy's face. Because here's the guy's face. If you think about it, the guy's face and the girl's face are the same poly, I bet you. The same poly loop. Like the topology is the same. They just move the vertices around to make the guy's face or the girl's face. Looks kind of neat. Now, how come their faces are kind of different and messed up? Is there a certain face you type in the prompt, like, I want a movie star look for my heroine? So it just picks that face for that thing. Like, this person's face is all jacked up. They got leprosy or something. I'm not even sure what's the context of this? They're on the set of a steampunk Wizard of Oz movie from the 80s? Are they dressed like they're from the 80s? I don't think so. These look like Winston Smith outfits from 1984. Are they making the 1984 movie while this is being made down the block? What's going on here? They're sharing the same outdoors? This looks like London. 1984 London that was bombed, nuked to death in 1963. So nothing's changed, in 20 years. Oceania over here, it looks like. Oh, finally, we got the lion, and the lion's using the guy's face. Just more exaggerated around the lip line, the nose. Okay. Because I've been watching those videos last week, the ones were Star Wars, but it's a 90s dark fantasy movie, or Lord of the Rings, but it's a 70s dark fantasy movie, and the latest one is what's that video game, Mass Effect, but it's a 70s sci-fi movie. It's like after a while, I'm already gonna know what the renders look like. Because after a while, you can kind of see all the permutations that this thing can do. Like they can't decide where this guy's lip line is. Is it here? Mouth is here, or is it here? Maybe it's down here. Where's his chin? Is it this one or this one? How many hands you got on your wrist there? What's going on there? How many fingers you have, mister? How many toes you got? Too many? So he's the lion. These are the guys operating the thing, the lights. This is probably the sound machine, amplifier thing, whatever. Whatever they call those things. The lights, the camera, you know, not the cameras, but you know what I mean. That looks cool. How many fingers? What's going on here? Got a mutilated hand. This one's got fingers wrapped up inside of fingers. Oh, here we go. The flying griffin. Is that what they're called? The flying lion things. Were those in Wizard of Oz? Did they have a flying lion? Was that from another movie? Toto has been... What? Oh, by the way, this is the kid version. Same girl's face, but just younger. His face again. Yeah, someone put a lot of work into the prompting and the revisions and the enhancers. Oh, that looks good. I like that one. I don't know where they got the color scheme from. I would say bisexual coloring wasn't used yet in steampunk. It's now a thing, I guess. We got a nose, we got lips, we got more, another set of lips. Okay. Who's this? Is this the house that fell on the Witch of the East or something? Now, what is that? What is this supposed to be? If that was in a kid's storybook, would it scare the kid when they look at the page? Yeah. And that might scare a kid, but the other one, I don't. What's going on over here? Who's this? These passengers waiting to get on their plane? What's going on? That's a little bit. What do they call that? Star Wars-y? You know, the Emperor shooting lightning at Luke. Now, I kind of know what this is, but who are these two guys? This guy's got three hands. Okay, what is this about? Who are these guys? Were there guys with goggle glasses in Wizard of Oz? I haven't seen that movie in like 30 years. Kind of a Flash Gordon vibe to me. They don't use baby blue in cyberpunk, I'm pretty sure. Actually, no, this is steampunk. Yeah, steampunk is mostly brass. They don't use baby blue. The music sounds like it's AI as well. Who's this, the wizard? But yeah, this is the default male face, I'm guessing, for these kinds of things. When the face is done really well, it looks like the guy from RoboCop, one of the baddies. He's the one that says, "Don't touch me, man." You know, the weird part is that guy and then the other guy who's all going, "Ugh!" And then he gets splattered on the windshield of a Ford. What were those called, cars called? The Ford. Oh, well, they were a big deal. They looked futuristic back then. I can't remember what they're called now. Those two actors were both in, guess which movie? They were in part one of Atlas Shrugged. I thought that was so weird. The two guys are in RoboCop. And then, what, 30 years later? No, 25 years later, something like that. They'd be in a movie together again. And they were playing good guys, I think, in Atlas Shrugged. Anyway, they got canceled. If you're an actor, you don't do Atlas Shrugged movies. You get yourself canceled. So I don't think they've seen work since then. That's kind of neat. I am the great and powerful Oz. Step forward, Tin Man. Derper derper. Meanwhile, here's derper derper derper. Someone didn't do the prompt right, so the actress, the default face didn't get put on. A different default. The derpa face got put on her. Is that his balloon ride? Here. Is that this that's his balloon ride, right? The wizard's gonna head back to Kansas or something? Maybe not. Who's that green thing? What's that? Why do I have hiccups? Hang on, hang on. I like this table slash chair setup, but it's like melted together. You got something weird on the door here. That's kind of interesting. Some poster. Got the headlights with the eyeballs inside of them. That's a thing with the AI. Oh, so that's the scarecrow, I'm guessing, right? But what is this then? Yeah, what are these? They got Fifth Element. Oh, Fifth Element as a Japanese film. Oh, do I want? It's got the same face, same girl's face. Yeah, what the heck? Let's watch it. Some of it. Okay, so she's got different eyes. Yeah, it's the same girl's face. Which scenes are these? This is a Japanese. I like, by the way, I like Japanese sci-fi movies from the 60s. They're pretty good. Not the Godzilla crap, but the actual Japanese. They had actual decent model builders and set designers for their movies. I mean, they were catching up quick. They got nuked. Remember, Japan got nuked. Well, not the whole entire island, but you know what I mean. And they recovered. In 20 years, they recovered. I mean, we helped them. That's, no one else would help them. So they're like, how do you guys make movies? I mean, they sort of, they had the Seven Samurai and all that kind of stuff going on in the 50s. But in the 60s, they went balls to the wall with their filmmaking. And, you know, they get the help of, was it Italians? They would get Italian actors. Anyway, Italy was kind of bizarre because for decades, the law of the land was everyone in a movie had to be redubbed. You had to redub everybody. It was the law until about, what, 5 or 6 years ago? Now, whew, you don't have to redub. So if Mel Gibson is ever in an Italian movie, guess what? You get to hear his voice, not some Italian actor's voice. What do we got here? What is this? Is this Clerks or something? What is this? Is this... Oh, what was that one movie? Silent Bob or something? But this is... Okay, I gotta think. And keep in mind, this is a Japanese film, so it's gonna have some fetishes, Japanese style in here. You got Lilu Carbon Dallas. Her face is different this time, but maybe the main characters get the face assigned to them, and then anyone else in the shot gets a generic face. Oh, here's a he/she over here. Why does the AI keep putting a thing in his forehead? What reference did that AI think it was needed from? Zorg. Kind of creepy. These are the same face, by the way. And what do we got here? Is behind the scenes stuff again? What is this? I'd argue that there's no fat people in Japan. That looks kind of cool. The police cars weren't black and white, though. But in Japan, this is... You know, I have to think. This is Japan, so... The Japanese version. So this is probably what their police cars would look like. What are we doing here? Trying to figure out who this guy is. Which character was he? There's the blue lady. She's like 70 now and she still sings this song live for some reason. People love it. What we got here? Mangalores? Is that a Japanese version of the Mangalore? Now, there's a scene where it's a deleted scene, I'm guessing, where Lilu is in her battle armor being transported, and they crashed on Mars or something. Anyway, she was in a suit. Maybe this is them trying to figure out what the suit looks like. Rudy Broad. I mean, he didn't have boobs, but, you know, whatever. Yeah, why is this one a bit weird? Now they say this one's a bit weird, or the next one's a bit weird. What is this supposed to be? I don't understand. What character was this in Fifth? I've seen that movie like 30 times. What character is this? Maybe when she's learning kung fu, and they take it a bit far, and she actually goes somewhere to fight in the ring with this robo kung fu thing. Because they don't have internet in Japan, you know, so they do it different over there. Well, that was interesting. What's the next one? No, I don't know what Dino Crisis is. Any more of these weird? Oh, here's 60s. 60s X-Men film. All the girls have the same face. All the guys have the same face. It's like... Yeah. Oh, here's a video. Probably talking about me or something in here. Anyway, next.